Hey, Myrtle! Hey, Myrtle! Hey, already! Hey, Myrtle!
Well, you're really adorable.
Hey, Myrtle! How's about going out to Sheepshead Bay?
Not with you, hey.
Why not?
Because you're a married man, and I simply do not associate with married men.
Since when? Yesterday?
Fresh. Listen, gather around the stoop. I have a very interesting story to tell you.
Oh, Myrtle, not again.
It's the story of my life. It's practically a saga. I was born of a poor but honest and respectable family at 437 and a half Nordstrand Avenue. Papa worked in the factory, and he loathed it. So after my education, where do I end up? Naturally, it's in a factory. Sometimes it got to be very monotonous, but I didn't mind. And one day, being desirous of a cigarette, I waltzed out onto the fire escape and leaned over the railing frontwards. And who should pass by but the new foreman? Oh, he was adorable. His name was Hugo. So I made some pretense of not caring for him, and I hollered, "Hey there, you with the stars in your eyes." He acquiesced. He was absolutely adorable. And the following Saturday night, we went to Coney Island. The night was young, and so we went from place to place like crazy mad.
Gee, it must have been grand and all.
And Hugo won me a Cupid doll.
Did you go to the movie?
Yeah.
What'd you see?
Saw Marilyn Monroe in Niagara.
Marilyn Monroe? Holy gee!
She certainly doesn't appeal to me.
Did you throw the darts and balls and hoops?
You bet your life. When we looped the loops, Hugo took off his shirt and he rang the bell.
He rang the bell?
He rang the bell, and just between you and the gatepost and I, we did everything money could buy. Oh, it was so perfectly marvelous. And then we went to his place. It was the first time I ever took off my shoes in a gentleman's quarters. I shall skip the details and simply intimate we spent a very pleasant weekend. Next day, I couldn't wait to tell my girlfriend Cassandra about the perfectly romantic experience which yours truly had just experienced. So we had a rendezvous on the fire escape. She was all ears, so I told her. And then she told me that Hugo was a married man, so I told her to mind your own business. The following Saturday afternoon, I was in Prospect Park, and there was Hugo playing with his three children. I made some pretense of not recognizing him. Hey there, you with the stars in your eyes. Listen to me, Hugo. As far as I'm concerned, I want no part of you. You are a married man. Kindly stay out of my life forever.
Yeah.
So that's why I can't go with you. You're married.
Oh, Myrtle, forget it.
I don't want to forget it. I want to carry my torch.
Ah, burn up.
Hey, where did you say you were going?
Sheepshead Bay.
Sheepshead Bay. Take me out to Sheepshead Bay.
Sheepshead Bay. I love to travel out to Sheepshead Bay. And hear the ocean waves singing to me, whispering low.
Take a ride in any canoe and paddle away in billin' coo.
Sheepshead Bay. Where you can flex your muscles out on the sand. Where you can drink your beer and throw out your can. Everything's free. Sheepshead Bay.
The men are stronger.
Sheepshead Bay.
And they're so virile.
Sheepshead Bay.
And are they sunburnt?
Sheepshead Bay.
And I really mean it.
Let's go out to Sheepshead Bay. Get out to Sheepshead Bay. Get out to Sheepshead Bay. Go! Sheepshead Bay. Sheepshead.